Did you know tonight's Young Talent Time is...
is brought to you by McDonald's Family Restaurants.
Hey.
The hop. must be the shirt.
Yeah, it must be.
Hi, everybody. That's nice. One of these days they'll get my name right after all these years. It's party night tonight, and we're turning the clock back to the 50s and the 60s, and we're going to do some of that early rock and roll stuff. That's Vinny underneath the sunglasses, by the way.
Michael Jackson?
No. Hey, I want to some friends of mine, and they're just really terrific. They do some 50s and 60s dancing. Have a look at this. This is Two's Company. Give them a clap. So tell me about this school teacher of yours, Joey.
All right.
I mean, what an exciting thing to have to do to perform on television in front of your school teacher. What's her name?
Mrs. Collins.
Mrs. Collins, and she's up there on the right-hand side. Good-looking school teacher, too. Hi, Mrs. Collins. Does he behave himself? Good boy, a wonderful kid. Thank you very much. Well done, Joey.
Thank you.
I wouldn't agree with that, could I? Yes, you are. You're great. You're a good boy. I always used to get in trouble at school. So does Mark, you know? Really, he does, Mark Stevens. Something happened to him the other day. We just happened to have the camera handy because somebody was sort of misbehaving and causing trouble between him and his girlfriend, and this is what happens. Here's Mark.
Cause the teacher saw the punch.
Yes, she did.
He was telling things that were not true about her. So I let him have it in the cafeteria. Now I'm staying. Staying in. While my baby's walking home. Son of a gun, I know she wouldn't be caught with him there. She don't know why he's got up his sleeve, but she would find out if I could only leave. Staying in,
yes, I am.
Staying in.
Where are you going?
Hi, Clancy. Sorry, I can't stay. I have to go to school for exams and I've got so much study to do.
What?
It's really worrying me.
Well, hang on a minute. Maybe I can help you.
Oh, Clancy.
Yeah. Now, I'll be the teacher, all right?
Okay. Here's some glasses.
Right, now, quick questions, okay?
Mm-hmm. Fire away.
Right, what does MacMillan spell?
Macmillan?
Yeah, right, clever girl. Oh, well. Now, what does MacMahon spell?
MacMahon?
Yeah.
McMahon?
Right. Very good. Now, what does MacHine spell?
McHine.
No, it spells machine, you silly dilly.
See, I'm not going past my exams. What will Dad say if I fail?
Oh, so is that what you're worried about? What Dad will say when your results come out?
He'll be really cross, I know it.
Well, when you show your Dad your exam results, give him this as well.
What's this?
Oh, I found it in the attic.
What is it?
It's one of your Dad's old exam results.
Gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Queen of the Hop. Our 1958 finalists are the wonderful Miss Summer. The beautiful Miss Winter. The stunning Miss Autumn. And the adorable Miss Spring. And while the judges make their decision, Joey, do you know the Queen of the Hop?
I think they're all beautiful.
Sure are.
Bye.
Back on stage, we will announce the winner. Judges, have you made your decision? Thank you. Drum roll, please. And the winner is the wonderful Miss Spring. Yay! Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everyone. I'd like to thank my mum for making my beautiful dress, my dad for paying for the hop tickets, and my brother for driving me here, and thank you everyone for being here.
Thank you, Miss Spring. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
Funny, but it's true. What loneliness can do. Since I've been away, I have nothing more to say. Walking back to happiness.
What has four legs and 16 wheels?
A zebra on roller skates!
Hi, Clancy.
Hurry, Renina.
Why are you on that ladder?
Well, I'm going to high school.
That's a good one. Look, the kids really get dressed up, don't they, on Young Talent Time? Let's have a round of applause for all our dressed-up kids. And what, Sean? What are you? You're a lion from The Wizard of Oz, it looks like to me. Is that right?
Yes.
And what's your name, sweetheart?
Siobhan.
Siobhan, beautiful name too. What's your giggle?
When were there only three vowels in the alphabet?
When were the only three vowels in the alphabet?
Before you and I were born.
Clever. That's a good one for a school show. And here's a little gypsy. What's your name, sweetheart? Lauren, you tell me your giggle, and you look at the camera there and tell everybody at home. That's
What's
it.
What's the ghost's favourite ride?
What's the ghost's favourite ride?
The roller coaster.
Yes.
like that. Okay, young man, go on, stand up so everybody can see you. What's your name?
Adam.
Adam, tell me your giggle.
What's Beethoven's favourite fruit?
What's Beethoven's favourite fruit? I can't wait.
Banana nana.
Okay, there's a present for you. And the last one, what's your name, sweetheart?
Angela.
Hi, Angela, you've got a beautiful smile. Pretty girl, too. And you've got a lolly in your mouth, haven't you? Can you talk and eat a lolly at the same time? Go and swallow it.
Go.
Okay, let me hear you giggle. Let's see if you can do it with a lolly in your mouth.
What do you call a deer with no eyes?
What do you call a deer with no eyes?
And no idea.
Okay. While we're at school, last week we had a very interesting experience at Young Talent Time, and a young boy called Little Stevie, he came along to the show and he did all sorts of amazing things. And then he went to school and he told everybody during show and tell what it was all about. So here he comes, boys and girls, mums and dads. Here comes Little Stevie Davis to do his show and tell for us. Here he comes.
Well, last week, it was really good, my show and tell, because last Saturday, I went to Channel 10, and I watched them make Young Talent Time, and I saw all the kids, and I saw Johnny and Clancy and all that, and there was this really good guy on called Steve Davis. And he did some really good stuff, like he could juggle three balls, and he could... No, please, save your applause, I've got a weak finish. And he could juggle three balls and do a few tricks, like this. But even better, he could juggle four balls.
Whoa!
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, hey, this guy is good. Yeah. Right, but hang on. Actually, before I go on, don't you hate it when you're doing something really important like national television and you find you've got a stone in your shoe? Boy, it feels much bigger than it actually is, too. Oh, thanks. And not only did he do the juggling, but he did this great magic trick.
Whoa!
He had this magic trick that had four pom-poms. There was a white pom-pom, and there was a red pom-pom, and there was a yellow pom-pom, and there was a green pom-pom. A blue pom-pom. Now the incredible, and it was joined with an orange stick in the middle. The incredible thing about this is the yellow pom-poms joined to the blue pom-pom like that. Incredible. But also, the red pom-poms joined to the blue pom-pom.
Ooh.
Now, if the red pom-poms joined to the blue pom-pom and the yellow pom-poms joined to the blue pom-pom, that means that if the blue pom-poms joined to the red pom-pom, the yellow pom-pom must be joined to the red pom-pom too. Which really had me amazed, because how could the yellow pom-pom be joined to the red pom-pom and the blue pom-pom? And the red pom-pom and the blue... No, save it. Now, if the yellow pom-pom's joined to the red pom-pom and the blue pom-pom's joined to the red pom-pom, leaves the white pom-pom up here, which is also joined to the red pom-pom. Now, if the white pom-pom's joined to the red pom-pom, the blue pom-pom's joined to the red pom-pom, and the yellow pom-pom's joined to the blue pom-pom, that means the white pom-pom must be joined to the blue pom-pom. And the red pom-pom. Now, if the white pom-pom's joined to the red pom-pom, and the yellow pom-pom's joined to the red pom-pom and the blue pom-pom, and the white pom-pom's joined to the blue pom-pom and the red pom-pom like that, now, if the blue pom-pom and the red pom-pom were exactly the same length, that means the yellow pom-pom would be joined to the blue pom-pom, the white pom-pom would be joined to the red pom-pom, and I was thinking, it's joined in the middle. But there's nothing in the middle. So I went up to this guy, Steve Davis, and I said to him, how did you do it? And he said, extremely well.
Yeah.
I love this. It's a very fast-moving world that we live in the 80s, and things just come and go and change so quickly, the fashions and just shapes of things, and the things you see on television just seem to come and go, don't they, in front of your eyes. One minute they're on, the next minute they're not. And that's why it's always a pleasure for me to speak to two people who share something very, very special, and that is 50 years of wedded bliss. Yes, this week, Beatrice and John Elliott have been married for 50 years. How about that? And these are your grandchildren? Great-grandchildren. Fantastic. You look so young for being married for 50 years. You must really get along well.
Get along very well.
Do you laugh a lot?
Why not?
Yeah, you've always got a smile on your face, John, haven't you? Now, listen, tell me
most
about...
times.
Excuse me, Beatrice, but I'm going to ask him about you, right? That we may discover some things about you that... that you may not want exposed on national television.
I don't think the show goes long enough.
No, you've done a lot of things in the 50 years,
yes,
I bet you.
Yes, we've done a lot of things.
And
yes.
You were married where?
In Perth.
Good old Western Australia. I bet it was the Presbyterian Church in St. George's Terrace.
It may have been well there. St. George's.
And does she cook well and do all those sorts of things well for you? But it takes more than cooking and all that stuff, doesn't it?
I'd be a walking advertisement, wouldn't I?
You look very, very healthy, John, yes. Yeah. And do you row a little occasionally? Do you have a little bit of a yell now and then?
Of course.
That's part of a happy marriage,
that's
is it?
That's right, yeah.
And who wins, Beatrice? Who wins the arguments?
I do, because he won't argue with me.
That's clever. That's very clever. See, the success for 50 years of wedded bliss is don't argue with your wife. I think that's a good idea. Say, yes, dear, you're right, dear. Is that the way
I've
to go?
I've never known a person that can disturb a newspaper in a flat 2 seconds better than my wife.
Beatrice, we've got some flowers for you.
Thank you, sir.
Some chocolates. That'll keep you going. And not only that, congratulations to both of you, and thanks for sharing this special week with us at Young Talent Time. And we've got a song, and I guess this is appropriate for all married people, because in all marriage I think you have to dream a little, and this is an appropriate song called All You Have to Do Is Dream, for Beatrice and for John Elliott on their 50th wedding anniversary. lovely song. Yeah. Don't they look good together? You look beautiful together, you guys. Very romantic and lovely. And that's for John and Beatrice. And again, happy 50th wedding anniversary, you two. And another 50 coming along, I hope so, for you. Good on you. What a great smile on his face. I was looking through our library footage the other day because we're doing a sort of 50s and 60s program tonight, and I found some footage of some of the stars of today. The way that, no, not me, no, we're not going to look at Johnny Young from that period. I don't want to get embarrassed on my birthday. But here are some people. You all know Glenn Shorrock, right? Yeah. And the Little River Band and everything. Well, in the 60s, particularly in the early 60s, he was with a band called the Twilights. And they were just the biggest band around Australia. The mums and dads will remember. Have a look at this. Here's Glenn Shorrock with the Twilights and a great song called Bad Boy.
Now, Junior, behave yourself. Buy a little rock and roll book on the magazine stand. Every time that he gets up, he's out to see the jukebox man.
Thank you. You like the movements? Now, Junior, behave yourself. Glenn's watching tonight because I know he enjoys young talent. He'll be falling off his chair. Okay, who's the biggest star in Australia today? Male star.
John Farnham.
I said, well,
we all this. We all know this.
Tell me this.
Funny. Here comes John Farnham, the way that he looked back in the 60s. And this is a song that you may not remember him doing, but it was from, I think it was from a show called Pippin. And that John starting with Colleen Hewitt. And here he comes. Have a look at Johnny Farnham, the way he looked then.
Talk about all those crazy dreams we're hoping will come true before our life is soon. And that's my favorite occupation with you.
Your hair is very similar to the way his hair was then, because that would have been around about... Actually, it would have been around about the King of Pop time. Remember John Farnham? The mums and dads will remember this. John Farnham used to win the King of Pop awards just about every week. Well, every year, anyway. Look, this is him with his King of Pop crown on. Okay, while we're looking back, Daryl Cotton, whose program Early Birds is now seen in Melbourne and Sydney, and very shortly will be seen right around Australia. And Daryl's a terrific fun guy. And it's a wonderful show, particularly for the people in Queensland and Adelaide. You'll be seeing Early Birds, I think, in about 3 or 4 weeks' time, if I'm not mistaken. Well, Daryl Cotton used to be a rock and roll star in the 60s too, and he used to sing with a band called The Zoot, which had some very famous people in it. Yeah, the Pink Suit was Bee Birtles, who went on to play in the Little River Band, and Rick Springfield, who's a big star in America, and of course, Daryl Cotton. But have a look at sweet Daryl, the way he looked then.
Whoa,
it was wild. Here he comes.
Donning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people. Until they all come from.
And I'd like to tell you that all that footage that you've seen just there of John Farnham of The Zoot and of The Twilights was all recorded right here in this very studio in the 60s.
Really?
There's a lot of, yes, a lot of history right here in this studio. When I first started to sing, I used to watch a program on the ABC every Sunday night. And it was the inspiration, I think, for so much of what's happened in the 60s in the rock and roll business in Australia. The show was called 6 O'Clock Rock and it starred Johnny O'Keefe. And this is a little bit of what it looked like. And see if the mums and dads can remember Johnny O'Keefe the way he looked then.
Come on, everybody, it's 6 O'Clock. Hi, once again, and welcome to 6 O'Clock Rock. We hope you're going to have a ball with us this afternoon. Particular hello to all the people that are tuning in for the first time. We hope you like the session. Shoot the band! Yeah. We've got a lot of new faces as usual on the program this afternoon. A little later we'll be having Dick Richards, and we've got some terrific film shots of Louis Prima.
Terrific. That was Noel Parker, who just walked through our studio floor, by the way. Thank you very much, Noel. Well done. Noel is the person who does all of our very special... Turn around and wave at everybody, Noel. Well done. Okay. And when Young Talent Time returns in the moment, we've got a closing tribute to Johnny O'Keefe, and everybody at home should kick off their shoes and everybody in the studio, because we're going to shout as we pay tribute to the great Johnny O'Keefe.
Me wanna shout, throw my head like a shot, put my hands up and stop. Come on now, don't forget to say you will. Don't forget to say better than I've been to myself. You know you make me wanna shout, hit my heels up and shout, kick my head back and shout, kick my heels up and shout. Come on now, come on now, take it easy, take it easy, take it easy, take it easy, take it easy. All right, come on now, come on now, come on now, come on now. A little bit softer now, 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 a little bit louder now, a little bit louder now, a little bit louder.
Certainly hope that the O'Keefe family... Wait, hang on, let me just say this.
I've got a special surprise for you.
You got a special surprise for me?
It's your birthday today.
Aww. I just
right,
cut the cake. Shall I cut the cake and make
you
a wish?
Don't
touch the bottom.
I won't touch the bottom.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. I got a good wish too.
Also, you weren't the only person doing some snooping this week.
Who's been doing some snooping?
Me. And the rest of the team. We were looking through some old tapes and we found footage of you in her. In 63 on your first appearance on television, Australia.
Getting oh no. Let's have a look at this. Incredible. That I have not seen for a long time. That was 1963, so that's 25 years ago.
To congratulate you on 25 years on television, This is from Television House and the Young Talent Team. And all of your viewers.
Isn't that lovely? Well, thank you. Lisa, I've got to tell you, I love it. 25 years on, I'm still having a good time. I started when I was one. I can't lie about that anymore, can I? Seriously, though, thank you very much for this. I can do the Logie speech that I had prepared now. Seriously, I have a good time. Thanks, kids. That's a really nice thought. And as I was saying, or trying to say before, I really hope... That's okay. I really hope that the family of Johnny O'Keefe, there's Vicky O'Keefe and all his other kids and Maureen and Robin and all the gang, enjoyed that little tribute to Johnny O'Keefe because he was a really fine man and he gave me a wonderful start in show business too. So let's hear it one more time for Johnny O'Keefe. In his memory. Okay. Thank you very much for joining us for another special Young Talent Time. Thanks to our two's company over here. Steve Davis, our special guest. And, of course, thanks to the kids for bringing another Young Talent Time to you. Next week is Easter, and we'll be bringing you a very special Easter program with Easter eggs for everybody who's coming into the studio. And we really hope you have a good Easter, everybody. La, da, da, and I hope... Good night, Danny. Thank you. Your dreams come true. Good night, Joey. Hey, by the way, if you've missed little Ricky, Ricky had a little bit of a fall during rehearsal today, but she's all well. She's back in the studio here, and she'll be back with us on the show next week. We love you, Ricky, and thanks for your hard work. Sorry you had to fall up to him. And we send all our love to you. And on behalf of our fine sponsors, McDonald's, see you next week, everybody. Bye for now.
Anna Nobin, Johnny Young and the cast choose to stay at the Southern Cross Hotel. Our weekly Young Achiever shares in the McDonald's Scholarship Fund. Young Talent Time is a Television House production for Network 10 Australia. Gavin Wood speaking.
Tonight's show is proudly presented by McDonald's Family Restaurants.